Do you know that heart can keep beating even when it is removed from the body? But why? We will find out the answer as we study the action potential in SA node in this video. Welcome back to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Let's get started. The heart generates impulses on its own to trigger a heartbeat. For this, the heart has three pacemaker tissues: the SA node, the AV node, and the Purkinje fibers. They all can generate impulses on their own. However, the rate of impulse generation is different. Normally, the SA node generates impulses faster than the other tissues. Because of the slower rate in the other tissues, an interesting thing happens. Let's say this is time 0 and the SA node and AV node both start generating impulses on their own at the same time. Because of the faster rate in the SA node, impulse first appears in the SA node and quickly spreads to the AV node. This incoming impulse stimulates the AV node even before the AV node has generated its own impulse. And this happens every time. So AV node is stimulated at the frequency of SA node. The same applies to the entire conductive system. So normally, impulses from SA node override all other tissues and the SA node controls the heart rate. But for any reason, if SA node gets slower than the inherent frequency of other tissues, the other tissue will generate its own action potential before the impulse from SA node reaches it. In that case, that tissue overrides all other tissues and becomes the pacemaker of the heart. Thus, the fastest of the pacemaker tissues controls the heart rate. As I have already said, normally the fastest one is the SA node. And that is the one that we will be studying in this video. The SA node or sinoatrial node is also called the sinus node. It is located in the right atrium near its junction with superior vena cava. It is a small and flat ellipsoid strip of specialized cardiac muscle. Now let's move towards action potential in SA node. But before that, let's quickly see basics behind it. So there are three main ions involved in the rhythmicity of the SA node: sodium, calcium, and potassium. Sodium and calcium concentration is higher outside the cell and they tend to diffuse in. As they are positively charged ions, their entry takes the membrane potential to electropositivity. Potassium concentration, on the other hand, is higher inside, so it tends to diffuse out. And the exit of positively charged potassium ions makes the cell electronegative. The balance between the movement of these ions controls the rhythmicity. With this basic cleared, now let's see the action potential in the SA node, starting with the resting membrane potential. It is about minus 60 millivolt. However, this resting membrane potential is not so resting in the pacemaker tissues. It is in fact unstable. The reason is slow sodium channels that allow an influx of sodium even without any external stimulation. This slow sodium entry slowly rises the membrane potential. The sodium current is sometimes referred to as funny current or IF. Researchers did not expect this inward sodium current at the end of the repolarization. So when they found it funny. Anyway, along with sodium, slow entry of calcium also contributes to the rise in the membrane potential. The contribution of calcium increases gradually. Eventually, the potential reaches the threshold, which is about minus 40 millivolt. So this was the phase of slow pacemaker potential. Next, at the threshold, more calcium channels open, resulting in a rapid influx of calcium. This produces upstroke, which is also called phase 0. Then the calcium channels close and potassium channels open. So calcium influx ceases and potassium starts leaving the cell. Exit of positive ions brings the membrane potential towards electronegativity. Thus, the action potential is terminated. This is phase 3. Wait, where is phase 1 and phase 2? Well, phase 1 is initial repolarization and phase 2 is the plateau. But they are seen in ventricular myocytes. They are not seen in the SA node. So we directly have phase 3 of repolarization. the potassium efflux continues for some time even after this. So the membrane is hyperpolarized. Now we have reached the potential from where we started. At this point, potassium channels start closing, so efflux of potassium decreases. And also, the sodium and calcium influx that we discussed earlier once again overbalances the potassium efflux. So there is a net entry of positive charge into the cell. So the membrane potential again moves towards the electropositivity. This phase is called phase 4. The potential reaches to the threshold and action potential is generated again. In this way, SA node keeps generating the impulses on its own. Impulses thus generated spreads to the surrounding atrial fibers and to the AV node. This spread eventually triggers a heartbeat. Thus, the SA node serves as the pacemaker of the heart. This property of being able to generate its own impulse is called automaticity. So that was all about the action potential in the SA node. Now let's have a quick summary. SA node is the normal pacemaker of the heart. Action potential in SA node involves slow pacemaker potential due to slow entry of sodium and calcium, upstroke due to rapid influx of calcium, and repolarization and hyperpolarization due to cessation of calcium entry and exit of potassium ions. Then potassium efflux decreases and slow entry of sodium and calcium again brings the potential to threshold to trigger the next action potential. Thus, the SA node keeps generating action potential on its own. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.